y'all ready? Cheers, my brother. Let's see this Viking.
How we doing, folks? I hear some of you out there. I said, well, how you doing, folks? So it's a little bit. So it's, Ninja, is there any way you can give me a little bit more of my guitar? If it's a big deal, don't worry about it. I think it should be okay. So, for the ones who've seen Andy and I and other projects, this is going to be a completely different thing, kind of mellow, low key. So, we do hope you enjoy it. I just want to say real quick, I want to thank Josh, Ninja, everybody, Daniel, all you guys have been fantastic, beautiful people. Thank you so much for having us. I have not met one douche since I've been here. All good people, so it's been fantastic. Is there anything we could put here so this doesn't fall down like the wine did there?
Yes.
I need this. This is my hard drive. My memory's gone and I've learned so many songs I just can't remember them all. Damn, this guy is so damn smart. I wouldn't even have thought that. Jesus. So last song was by one of my all-time favorite songwriters, Elliott Smith. God bless him. I love him so much. We're mostly gonna play some covers. We're gonna kind of do them our own way. But Andy and I just started working together, and we're actually starting to write songs. And hopefully this turns into something here in the near future. But as of now, you're kind of seeing the beginning of it. And we're playing songs that we love, and hopefully that's gonna turn into some original music here soon. But here's one you may have heard.
Yeah.
So I just gotta tell you now, I'm dealing with the cold I've been dealing with. My voice is totally shot, but it is what it is. You guys get to hear the good, the bad, the ugly, and that's just the way that it goes. So I hope you know that rhyme. So what if we do let's do original. Crazy Lord? So I got a cool story on this. About a year and a half ago, I read this article in Sports Illustrated where certain athletes were taking acid, and they were taking it in small amounts where they didn't get really, really fucked up, but they just took enough to kind of heighten their senses a little bit. And so right around the same time, a hippie friend of mine had some acid on Altoids, and she asked me if I wanted some. I'm like, yeah. I hadn't done it in years. I'm like, you know what? Yeah, I think I will. So I took a few of them, and what I did is I split them up either in the halves or in the quarters, and I kind of took that same philosophy. Instead of getting really, really fucked up on acid, just take small amounts and kind of see, for musically, you see what happened. So this one night I did it, not a lot happened. I listened to music, not a big deal. And the next day, the next morning when I woke up, I had all these lyrics in my head. So I grabbed my phone, got on the notes, and I just put them down as fast as I could. And typically when I write a song, it starts out with a guitar, you know, guitar riff, and then a vocal melody, and then lyrics. Where this song was complete backwards, where it was lyrics first, vocal melody, and then a song. So the next morning, as soon as I got the lyrics, I went in and I recorded it, and the song is called Crazy World. Originally, I was going to call it Acid on Altoids, but yeah. I didn't think that was really, didn't think that was appropriate. And I still have to have cheat sheets on this fucking song, you know? It's horrible. I feel like an old man. My memory's gone. People out there are like, oh, quit taking acid. Oh, shit, I can't find it. I'm going to try to wing it. I can't find it. Hit the gun. Jesus Christ. Oh, here we go. Crazy World. That's not it. Okay, I'm just going to wing it. Here we go.
Crazy world, we are shit.
Whenever I'm not around, you're so fucking sad.
There's a hole.
Jesus Christ, I have nothing else to do. No tears have been used. It don't stop to count the years. Sweet songs never last too long. Shannon's, anyway, but this song is called Change. And I'm gonna need help singing it because I can't hit my high register. My voice is a little fried, but help me out. If you know the song, I know you guys know the song. So.
I'll never live that way.
For me, you know, I'm in my 30s, so I'm a grunge baby. I'm a 90s baby. And Stone Temple Pilots was such a big band for me growing up. But then as I got older, I got into other music and Mars Volta and Tool and Radiohead and other things. I kind of forgot about that time in my life. And after he passed away, I went and revisited his Stone Temple Pilots records. And what a great band they were, man. Amazing band. And I think they didn't necessarily get the attention they should have got it. But anyways, this is one of my favorite STP songs. This song is called Big Empty. And Andy and I are about to play it for them.
Time to take her home, but it is Thank you.
Giving in to the laws of reality.
told me there's a girl out there who loves the eyes and flowers in her hair. Children, 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 children great time. Yeah.
Oh, that was amazing. That
you
was
guys,
amazing.
Right here. Time for you. I guess we should have played some Skinner or something.
Yeah.
Maybe we could have had a great crowd in here. Maybe some, I don't know, Burr Brooks or something.
Thank you.
So this next song we're gonna do is again one of those nostalgic songs I grew up listening to years ago. I kind of forgot about. Andy mentioned this song, and I was like, "Oh shit, I remember it." He asked me he was like, "Did you ever listen to the Verb?" And I'm like, "I love the Verb." And so, anyways, that went to learning the songs.
Yeah.
Thanks for having us. Let's have a good time tonight.